How do you make one of the world's busiest collaboration hubs more collaborate-y? You make it into a low-code app development platform that anyone can use to quickly and easily build an app or an intelligent chatbot to improve your work process, support your employees, and yes, to share snacks. In this episode of The Solution Show with Corey, Bryony Wolf will join me to show and share how the Microsoft Dataverse for Teams brings the revolution to the Workplace Hub. Thank you all and welcome to The Solution Show with Corey. I am so excited about the show today because I absolutely love Power Apps. And today we are going to see how it is coming to a new level of awesomeness with some new and recent announcements. Bryony Wolf here is going to talk to us about some really, really cool stuff. Bryony, can you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about what you do?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Corey, and thanks for having me. So, Bryony Wolf, I am the product marketing manager for Power Apps, which is a app development platform that's part of our broader sort of Power Platform suite, which is the Microsoft sort of low-code tools. And what is super exciting about low-code, not just how quickly it's growing and being adopted, but really what you can do with it and how it empowers really everyone to be able to do pretty amazing things.
So you have some pretty cool things that you're going to show us today about how we can take some of this power and really extend it out into many more end customers at each one of our customer sites. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have just announced very recently Microsoft Dataverse for Teams. And what that is that is a essentially built-in low-code data platform for Microsoft Teams, so especially for Teams. So if you think about our millions of team users that are using that as a hub to collaborate, to get all their work done, we've now taken all the goodness from the Power Platform and we've essentially put it into Teams. So now what you can achieve is just sort of multiplied. So a little bit, I can tell you more about like what that entails, if that's helpful.
Yeah, that would be great. In addition to, let me just acknowledge the name is fantastic, Dataverse. Cool. It makes me feel like I'm flying through a space of Power Apps. And so I don't know if that's what you have, we're going for, but that's at least what I think of. But yeah, Walk us through actually for everyone else while I'm dreaming of that traveling. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about what we can do with this.
No, absolutely. So really, it just makes sort of building solutions within Teams much easier. So anyone can really, they can build, they can edit, they can share, they can use their solutions all from within Teams. And you mentioned Power Apps, and Power Apps, our App Studio is now embedded within Teams. And I'd love to show you that in a little bit. But what we've also just made generally available is, you know, intelligent bots, so Power Virtual Agents are now also embedded within Teams. So anyone that has sort of any subject knowledge expertise can actually create an intelligent bot within Teams for their team or for their entire org to, you know, really scale support with internally. So it's super exciting.
Got it. So this is both Power Apps, but then also the ability to do bots and in fact, in some cases, bring them together, perhaps the data being shared between them. Very, very cool. So look, you promised to show something, so I would actually love to see. So this is actually building an app in the experience. Let's see what you've got.
The solution I'm going to show you is something that is really horizontal. It's relevant for so many teams, and how you can build sort of an event app for a specific team. You know, you can create your sessions, your capacity, what snacks are you going to have, which is very important. So really, you can manage that then end to end, all within your team, who will then collaborate in one place. So I'm really excited to show you this demo. And I think the beauty is really in the simplicity. So you can see what you're seeing is Power Apps is now actually embedded in Teams. And you've quickly just opened up and said, create an app all from within Teams. So there's no code. You can just name your app, whatever you'd like to sort of name it. And now what you can do is, because your data platform is essentially built into Teams, it's a little bit like, you know, creating columns with an intelligent Excel sort of built into Microsoft Teams. So you can see what's happening on the screen now is this is an event solution. So they're just creating like the speakers, how many people can be in each session. And this is essentially the data framework behind your solution. And you can see how easy it was to sort of build that out. There was no code involved. It was very manual. You know, you can just fill it in like it was an Excel sheet. And here you can see how it comes to life then within the solution. And publishing, so you can deploy and publish and preview in Teams your Power App with one click. And now what you'll actually be able to see is you can go into your team where you've built your app, and you can actually see that solution and how it would look like for all of your users. So it's really that easy to get started.
What an awesome demo. I mean, it's so cool to be able to see that actual development happening inside Teams. But again, with just sort of the knowledge and experience of using Excel and sort of a PowerPoint design experience, all embedded in Teams and being able to build such a powerful app, again, centered around snacks. That was what I heard, was that it was mostly focused on snacks and then some other things. So that I think that was the point you were making. Really, really cool and really awesome. You know, one thing that I'm sure everyone's sort of wondering, which is great, and you've shown an awesome demo, but are there examples of sort of real customers and what they're doing with this? Like what have you enabled and empowered with customers to be able to do this type of building and deployment within Teams in their environments?
Yeah, no, absolutely. So a lot of people are using the Power Platform, and we hope even more people are going to be using the Power Platform in Teams. So I think something like 97% of the Fortune 500 are using the Power Platform today. You know, a customer that comes to mind to me is sort of T-Mobile. You know, they are growing incredibly fast. They've got, you know, 98 million customers in the US. It's a lot of customers to look after, and it's super important to them. So they've really been using the Power Platform in a bunch of different ways, you know, from building something that's sort of an inspection app from a template that they then customize within Teams, to you know, using Microsoft Dataverse and building a really complex end-to-end Power Platform Power App solution that sort of has managed their entire intake process for how they, you know, invest technology, their priorities. So it's been really, really sort of great to see.
They and multiple snack-based apps as well.
I'm sure they are.
How could you not?
I mean, so I imagine some of the apps. So what they've really done is embrace low-code as a, you know, it is a little bit like the low-code revolution. Like they have a champions group. They have, I think, 9,000 app makers, 1,500 flow makers. They've collectively made, I think, 3,000 apps and something like 74,000 flows. So it really is a little bit like a revolution. And it's not, you know, I'm sure there is one solution that is about snacks within that. But, you know, it really shows how you can have, you know, amazing transformation. And I think those champions come from across the business, from retail, from their retail teams, from their finance teams. And they've all come together to solve problems. And that really is what is particularly exciting. And then by having it all in Teams, where everyone, you know, collaborates, you know, it's just so much easier.
That's fantastic. Thank you so much. I mean, what an amazing, amazing story with T-Mobile, and what an amazing announcement. Is there anything that you'd sort of add, any additional announcement or aspect of the announcement that you wanted to just make sure people are aware of, or let's just go get to building some apps?
No, I think we've had a great chat, and I think the only thing I'd say is it's so easy to get started. I think I'm going to share like a 3-step guide with you. That's three easy steps for, I know you know how to make tips, but for everyone that's been watching, to go off and build their first app.
Thank you so much, Bryony, for an awesome demo and really an awesome product. What a really cool thing for us to see. She said it right. This low-code motion really has become a revolution. We are seeing companies take it on full steam ahead and develop an entire new set of developers within their company to be able to build out solutions. It really is as simple as you saw. If you can use Excel, if you can use PowerPoint, now you can build an app. And we have hundreds of thousands of organizations doing just that. T-Mobile, American Red Cross, Capital Records, all of them leveraging Power Apps in a really, really exciting and powerful way. And now with Dataverse, you can do it right inside Teams. You can build in Teams, and then you can leverage Teams to create a collaborative experience as part of those applications. It really brings all of your people together and enables new development to take shape and take off into the Dataverse, as I previously mentioned. Thank you so much for your time. I hope you enjoyed this show. Really exciting to see these demos and these new announcements. And I hope we'll see you next time on the Solution Show with Corey.